Hello everyone. Today we will start a new procedure, that is intravenous injection. So intravenous injection, it is a most important procedure, and it is in this procedure we have to see many things and we have to remember many things. So why we will give this intravenous injection? So intravenous injection, it will be given to the injection through the veins and the medication which will be absorbed rapidly with the help of this intravenous injection. So when we will discuss about this intravenous injection procedure, in that first we will discuss about the cannula and the infusion set. So first is the cannula. A cannula, it is a flexible tube that can insert it into the body. The cannula means with the help of this cannula only the medicine which will be entered into the patient's body through the veins. A venous cannula is inserted into a vein for the administration of the intravenous fluid. So a venous cannula which will be inserted into a vein, and why it will be inserted? It will be inserted for the administration of the intravenous fluid for obtaining blood samples. It will be also used for the blood samples and for administering the medication. So generally, if we have to give the medicine to the patient through in the vein, and we have to take the sample of blood, so in that time we will use cannula. So through the cannula we will take the blood, and after that we will give the injection or IV fluid to the patient. Then parts of an IV infusion set. So in this you will see, this is this IV infusion set, it will be a connector in between the cannula and the patient's cannula and the IV bottle. So in this you will see, this is the spike. This spike, it will be inserted into the IV bottle. The next is the air vented. So when it will be open, so air, it will be enter into the IV bottle so that the negative pressure which will be reduced. Then this one is the drip chamber, means we will see that how much drip which will be coming in 1 minute, if there will be some calculation of the drip. Then this one is the solution filter. This is the solution filter, the solution which will be filtered, and in this tubing it will be entered. Then next is this one is tubing. Then this is the roller clamp. Roller clamp means we have to give the fluid in how much speed. So it will be controlling the speed of the drops. Then this is the injection site. Then this is the connector. This connector, it will be connected into the cannula. And this needle, so the needle, it will be a cover, or it will be sterile, and it will be it will be prevent from the contamination of this connector. Then what are the types of cannulas are? So there will be four types of cannulas. So IV cannula, that is pen like model. Then IV cannula with wings model, IV cannula with injection part model, and IV cannula Y-type model. So this is the picture of the pen-like model. You will see in this there will be no wings. So this is pen-like model. So we have to insert it into the patient's vein, and we will give the, and in this according to the there will be different sizes, and there will be different colors. Then this is the wings with wings model. So in this you will see there will be wings. This is the wings. So with the help of wings we have to insert the cannula, and here it will be written the gauze or the size. So this one is 14 gauze, and the color you will also identifying with the color, that is red color. Then 16 gauze, that is gray color. Then 18 gauze, that is green color. Then 20 gauze, that is pink color. Then 22 gauze, that is blue color. And 24 gauze, that is 24 yellow color. So in this there will be one thing you should remember, that the gauze which will be less, but the size which will be more, means the thickness which will be more, and the size which will be also increased, but the gauze which will be decreases. For example, this yellow color cannula, you will see the size of this cannula, which will be very small, but the gauze or the size, it will be 24. So there will be some this gauze number, it will be given like this only. Then this is with injection part model. So in this you will see the injection is there. This is injection light model. So in this you will also see the color which will be present, that that will be green, pink, blue and yellow. In this also the yellow color size, which will be very short. Then this is wire type model. So in this wire type model, cannula, it will be used in different areas, and according to the requirement only we will use this type of cannulas. Then size of cannula. So in this what are the color, what are the gauze, and what are the extended diameter, what is the length, then what water flow rate and recommended uses, means where we will use this type of cannula. So this one is orange, that is 14 gauze. So in that slide you will see the color which will be showing the red, but it is a orange color. So the orange color gauze, which will be 14, 2.1 mm, 45 length, that will be 45 mm. Then water flow rate, that will be 240 ml per minute minus. And when we will use, when the patient is having any trauma or any accidental injury, and if we have to give the rapid blood transfusion, if the patient is having the problem of hypovolemia, the volume of the fluid which will be decreased in the body, so in that time we will use, or during the time of surgery, because in that time the patient need more fluid and the rapid infusion which will be also required. So in that time we will not use that this yellow or purple color. Then next is the gray color. The gray color, the gauze, that will be 16 gauze, 1.8 mm, 45 mm, then 180 ml per minute. Then rapid fluid replacement, when we will we have to provide the rapid fluid replacement, or if the patient is having trauma, or rapid blood transfusion. Then next is the green, 18 gauze, 1.3 mm, that will be 32 mm, and 90 ml per minute, rapid fluid replacement, and trauma rapid blood transfusion. Means these cannulas which will be used in emergency situation. Then next is the pink, so 20 gauze, 1.1 mm, 32 mm, and 60 ml per minute. Most infusion, means it will be used in most infusions when we will give the rapid fluid replacement, or if the patient is having the problem of trauma or routine, it will be used for routine blood transfusion, not for rapid blood transfusion. Then next is the blue, 22 gauze, 0.9 mm, 25 mm, and 36 ml per minute. Most infusion, it will be also used for neonates, pediatric, older adults, and routine blood transfusion. Then next is the yellow. Yellow, 24 gauze, 0.7 mm, 19 mm, and 20 ml per minute. In the water flow rate, you will see the flow rate according to the size, the flow rate which will be decreases. So in this yellow color, it will be most infusion in neonates, pediatric, older adults, routine blood transfusion, or neonates or pediatric blood transfusion. The next is the why this will be used, because the neonates vein which will be very thin, so in that time we will use this small size of the cannula. The next is the purple. The purple color, that will be 26 gauze, 0.6 mm, 19 mm, and 13 ml per minute. So it is a pediatric. It is used for the pediatric or neonates only. Then intravenous administration. Needle is inserted into the vein. Direct IV or IV push or in IV infusion. Means when we will inserted a needle into the vein, that will be direct. Sometime we will directly insert a needle into the vein for taking the blood sample, or for giving the injection directly to the vein, or IV push or IV infusion. This is the most rapid route of the absorption of medication. As I have already told you that when it will be required for rapid absorption of the medicine into the patient's body. In that time, we will use this intravenous administration. Then angle of insertion is 25 degree. Here you will see the degree of the insertion, that will be 25 degree, and this is the vein. Then definition, intravenous therapy is frequently used with hospitalized patient to prevent or treat fluid and electrolyte imbalance. So intravenous therapy is frequently, it is used frequently, and it will be with hospitalized patient to prevent or treat fluid or electrolyte imbalance. Means if the patient is having the problem of dehydration, but the dehydration which will be not severe, so in that time we will providing the intravenous therapy to the patient to prevent the fluid or electrolyte imbalance. But if the patient is having the problem of any accidental injury or a severe fluid loss, so in that condition we have to provide the fluid and electrolyte imbalance, and it is for the treatment. It is introduction of fluid into the patient using an intravenous route. The nurse is responsible for initiating, monitoring, and discontinuing the intravenous infusion. Means it is the responsibility of a nurse for initiating or monitoring and discontinuing the intravenous infusion. Then next is the what are the sites of this intravenous injection. So here you will see there will be basilic vein. So in this is the basilic vein, this is the cephalic vein, this is the radial vein, and this is the median cuboidal vein. So in this you will see dorsal veins, median vein, radial vein, cephalic vein, and on the foot the veins are great saphenous vein or dorsal plexus. So in foot also we will give the injection if the patient, what are the conditions, means when the patient is having, if the patient's vein which will be not seeing in the hand, or the if the patient is having the severe dehydrated, or if the patient is having any burn injury, so that we will not inserted the in that hand area, arm area, we will not insert it. So in that time we will select the foot. Then purpose of intravenous infusion. So the purpose of intravenous infusion, that is to provide patient with fluid when adequate fluid intake cannot be achieved through oral route. So we have to provide the patient with fluid. Means when the patient is not having the proper, if the patient is not able to take the proper amount of fluid from the oral route, so we have to achieve, or we have to maintain the patient's fluid or electrolyte balance. So in that time, and we have to provide the adequate amount of fluid to the patient's body, we have to give the intravenous infusion. Then when the patient is unable to swallow, if the patient is unconscious, or if the patient is having any surgery in the neck, or if the patient is having any carcinoma in the oral cavity, so there will be many things. So the patient, when the patient which will be not able to swallow the food, so in that time we will providing the intravenous infusion to the patient, so that the patient's fluid or electrolyte which will be maintained. Then when it is undesirable for the patient to take fluids or food by mouth, means in post op patient for 2 days or 3 days, it will be the nil by mouth which will be required. So when it is undesirable for patient to take fluids, means when the patient which will be not able to take fluid or food from the mouth, so in that time we have to also give this fluid from the intravenous infusion, and it will be mainly used in the patient who are having the problem of post operative. Then to keep the vein open for administration of drug or when waiting for blood transfusion. Why we have to give the intravenous infusion? To keep the vein open. Means sometime if we will not give the medication or any intravenous infusion through the vein, so in that time there will be some clot formation which will be there, and the obstruction which will be also there. So to keep the vein open for administration of drug, or when waiting for, or if we have to give the blood transfusion, so in that time we have to give the intravenous infusion. To maintain and correct the electrolytes of the body when the patient is losing fluid or salt in excess, like in persistent diarrhea and vomiting and in severe burns. So we will also providing the intravenous infusion therapy to the patient to correct the electrolyte imbalance. So electrolyte imbalance in the patient's body, and when the patient is having the problem of this electrolyte imbalance in the patient's body, when the patient is having the problem of severe diarrhea or severe vomiting or in severe burn also. Then types of intravenous infusion. So in types of intravenous infusion, we will see there will be different types of solutions. So when you will go to the hospital, in that time you will see there will be different types of IV solution. That will be normal saline, NS or Ringer lactate, that will be RL, then DNS, dextrose normal saline, then dextrose 25%, and then there will be many fluids which will be present, and then metronidazole also, there will be many fluids. So the distribution of the fluid or the types of the intravenous infusion, that will be isotonic solution or hypotonic solution. So isotonic solution means they have the some osmotic pressure as that found within the cells. Means in this you will see that they have same osmotic pressure, means in the fluid they have the same osmotic pressure as the found within the cells. It means in our cell the same osmotic pressure which will be also present in the this fluid. So in this osmotic pressure means the pressure that would have to be applied to pure solvent to prevent it from passing into given solution by osmosis. Means higher concentration to lower concentration are often used to express the concentration of the solution. Means it is the pressure that would have to be applied to poor solvent. Means it is a pure solvent to prevent it from passing into a given solution by osmosis, and it will be used to express the concentration of the solution. So used to expand intravascular compartments and thus increasing circulating volume. Example, the example of this isotonic solution, that will be normal saline 0.9%. Then next is the Ringer lactate. Then they are also known as a plasma expanders. It will also comes under the plasma expanders. Then next is the hypotonic solution. So in hypotonic solution, have less osmotic pressure. In this, by the name itself, we will identify that hypo. Hypo means decrease. So or less, so have less osmotic pressure than the cell. In this you will see the fluid's osmotic pressure which will be less than the cell. When infused, it raises serum osmolarity. Means when we will infuse this solution into the patient's body, so in that time it will be raises or it will be increases the serum osmolarity pressure than the cell. And it causes body fluid to shift out of blood vessels, and it will be causing the body fluid which will be enter into the patient's body. Means it will be shift to out of the blood vessels. Means the body fluid which will be shift out. ये जो body fluid है वो क्या होती है, shift हो जाती है. किसमें? Shift out of, मतलब ब्लड वेसल्स के बाहर ये शिफ्ट हो जाती है. सो इट द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस हाइपोटोनिक सॉल्यूशन, दैट इज 5% डेक्सट्रोज इन वाटर. देन नेक्स्ट इज द हाइपरटोनिक फ्लूइड्स. सो इन दिस यू विल सी हाइपर मींस इंक्रीज और मोर, सो हैव अ ग्रेट ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर. So in this you will see there will be great osmotic pressure than the cell. When infused, it raises serum osmolarity. So in this you will see it will be also raises the serum osmolarity pressure, pulling fluid from cells and interstitial tissue into vascular space. Matlab ye kya karta hai, fluid ko it will be pulling fluid from cells se fluid ko le karke interstitial tissues mein jata hai, into the kahan se jata hai, it will be inserted into the vascular space. So the example of this hypertonic solution, that is 5% dextrose in normal saline and 5% dextrose in Ringer lactate. So we have to mix the solution. So these are the types of intravenous solutions that will be isotonic. In isotonic, you will see the osmotic pressure, which will be normal. The cell and the osmotic pressure, which will be normal, but in hypotonic solution have less osmotic pressure as compared to the cell. And in hypertonic solution, you will see it will have a great osmotic pressure than the cell. Then what are the indications for IV medication? So the indication that will be intravenous access to patient's circulatory system. So when we have to give the intravenous access to the patients, when we have to give the circulatory system, or we have to give the injection to the blood or into the veins, so that the injection which will be absorbed. So in that time, we will give the intravenous medication to the patient. Administration of medications and fluid as well as blood collection. It will be also used for administration of the medication and fluid as well as the blood collection. If we have to collect the blood or we have to take the sample, in that time we will use for this intravenous therapy or intravenous injection. And what are the contraindication? IV access should be attempted as distal as possible. Avoid veins that cross over joint. Means we will avoid the veins that will be cross the over joint, and local infection or injury. If the patient is having in local infection or injury in the site of intravenous area, so in that area we will not injected a cannula. Then extremities with renal shunts or fistula. If the patient is having renal shunt or fistula, means the patient who are having the problem of CRF or ARF, and in the patient if this renal means the blood transfusion or the blood purification which will be occur, so in that time we will not use that site, means extremities with renal shunt, jahan pe renal shunt bana hua hai ya fir fistula bana hua hai, for purification of the blood. So in that time we will not use, this is the contraindication for IV medication. So these all are today's topic. In next class we will discuss about what are the procedures, what are the complications of this intravenous therapy, what are the equipments which will be used for the patient who are undergone with this intravenous injections. So today's topic, this much only. So thank you everyone.